Hey there. All right, I've been playing around with these Mergafogas. I've got a Murph and a Base Murph, and I've been trying out this thing as each of them has two outputs, a left and a right. Just taking one of them and plugging it straight back into the pedal, and then the other one is going to my audio interface, which you're listening to, and creating feedback loops. Where, when you bring different bands or frequencies in, it changes the pitch of the feedback that's running through the pedal, which is different in each stage of the sequence, and you can get some interesting rhythms and patterns out of it. So one of the problems that you'll encounter is because different bands are sent out of different outputs. Some of them are going straight through the loop and never actually exiting the pedal, and then you get these kind of silent stages. But one way of fixing that is to send both outputs into a mixer and then use the effects end to return it back to the pedal, maintaining the feedback loop, but where you still get to hear both outputs so you don't get these kind of dead zones. Set that up. Okay, so I've set that up with the two outputs going into a mixer and the effects send from both channels being fed back into the pedal, and then the output from the mixer going into the audio interface, which you can hear. So with the exactly the same settings, I can now turn it on and you hear the channels that were silent before. Okay, another fun patch I've set up here is using the square wave output from the CP251 to clock two fogas together. And then we can use the same sort of feedback patch. So this is running into both pedals, running back out into the mixer, and you'll get these sequences that are in time with one another. Lots of fun.